If I didn't care more than words can say, if I didn't care, would I feel this way? If this isn't love, then why do I thrill? And what makes my head go round and round while my heart stands still? If I didn't...
Dad, I wanted to talk to you about this firestorm.
Whose baby is that?
It's the gay couple's baby. I told you I was looking after her.
Looks a lot like me. Weird.
Dad, can you please stop playing the piano? I want to talk to you.
Sweetie, I can't pull out of this stunt right now. I need the respect of the Wellington Stunt League. Wellington, Wellington, Wellington Stunt League, yes.
Dad!
God, Beth, what'd you do that for?
You're not a very good stuntman, are you?
Not on the piano!
Okay.
Look, Beth, let me ride this motorcycle through the window tomorrow. Hopefully after that we can talk about the fire stunt. How does that sound?
Good, hopefully.
Beth?
What?
I think I know what you're thinking.
What, you're not going to do the stunt?
Oh, no, I thought you might want to go for a curry.
Hello, I'm the narrator. Why have you started without me? Oh, you know people think narrators are always there, even when they're not talking, but that's not true.
Yeah, can someone ask that stuntman to drop his visor, please, before we start?
I'm not listening.
Rolling.
And... action!
Confirm that stuntman went through the wrong window?
Confirmed.
Okay, can I get a yes or a no that window was made of real glass?
That's a yes.
Right. Can somebody get me a coffee, please? Black, no sugar.
Oh, yeah. Black, two sugars.
I'll have a latte.
Which one?
Surprise me. But don't forget the little... stick.
Yeah. I'll make that two sticks.
Oh, and when you're done, you better get that man a ambulance. Okay, thanks.
Oh my god. Nurse.
Oh, tomorrow.
I need morphine. I'm in agony.
42-year-old male presenting acute signs of trauma.
Please, I just need some morphine. Please.
Patient is hysterical and thinks I work here.
What, and you don't?
I do. I'm on holiday. This is research for my novel.
You wear a uniform.
Yeah, sometimes I do that.
Hey, good-spirited jousting.
Yes.
Nobody suffers.
Where are you going? I'm really suffering here.
Gary.
Hey,
why did you not tell me about this stunt?
What?
Who's in the movie? Is it Brad Pitt?
Doc, am I okay to go? I've got to set myself on fire tomorrow.
It's in a mole.
What?
It's quite unusual.
Unusual? Is it bad?
Yeah, but you need to be serious with me now. Is Brad Pitt in your movie?
What about my mole?
Yeah, it's not really a time or place for those sorts of discussions.
Time or place? We're in a hospital. Doc.
I'm not here as your doctor. I'm just here as your friend now. You're very best friend.
Oh, I wish I had a friend like that.
I will need you to book into my surgery about that, probably within the next week. That sort of one often ends badly. It's good to see you, Gary. Look, we'll talk soon, okay? I'll be in touch.
Oh, my God.
see now I don't want you to set yourself on fire, Dad.
Sweetie, look. It was just a miscommunication on set. It's fine. Beth.
Dad, when Mum left, who did I choose to stay with?
Me?
I'd stay with Gary.
Exactly. And does that even mean anything to you?
Honey, I need to do this. It might be my last chance. I've got a very odd-shaped mole. Hey, Beth.
Mr. Jim, I've got just the thing to help you overcome your fear.
Oh, I probably should mention. That's Albert, Gary's adopted son. Gary agreed to be the godfather for his friend Bill, his Subaru car mechanic. Gary had a very unreliable Subaru wagon, and he didn't realise what a godfather actually meant. Anyway, a long story short, Bill was tragically crushed by a 94 Subaru. And now Gary is Albert's father.
Hello, Gary. I am Dr. Lichtenstein. Tell me your deepest worry.
Wow, 15 seconds ago I would have said being burnt alive.
It's a new puppet show I'm working on, where I get to help and entertain.
Right.
I call it help entertainment.
I can see how you make that connection.
You know, it'd be great to have you on my show sometime.
You've got a show?
It'll happen.
Yeah. Yeah, it will happen.
Yeah, I better shoot off, you know, busy rehearsing.
Show business.
Classic father-adopted son moment.
Not quite done yet, said the little fellow. Give it 2 more minutes. Come on, said Big Jim.
It's like when I'm talking to Dad, he's not even there.
Beth, Beth. Let me tell you something about the Kiwi Man. We don't like being talked to. We need to be part of the dance.
Oh, please, another dance reference?
It's a very versatile metaphor.
Stop it, Albert. No one is interested in watching Dancing with Puppets.
Not puppets, celebrity puppets. Remember that.
Whatever. How do I get Dad to listen to me?
Yeah, I've got to be honest with you there. The man's a complete mystery. That's why we get along so well. Hey, Gary, I'll just be 1 minute.
Continue gazing into the spiral. Deeper and deeper into the spiral. The hypnotic spiral. I am a hypnotist. Now gaze below into the bowl, which is now resplendent with exotic fruits and nuts. Is it not?
No.
How about cheeses?
No.
Mixed cheeses?
No.
Grapes?
No.
Like a single solitary grape?
No.
What do you see?
Bowl.
Look, I'll dim the lights. Dimming the lights is going to it's going to help.
No,
really
no, thank you for coming in. You've clearly got lots of potential. Yeah, yeah. And I'll give you a call. I'll be in touch.
Yeah, you have my number, right?
Yes, yeah, I do, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You have my number.
Yes. A fly to eat shit, but damn, I would tap that. I love big dudes, bro.
You did? Well, I'm.
Yeah, it's never gonna happen. Look, can I be completely honest with you, please? Even as your agent?
Right.
If you don't set yourself on fire, they are going to set me on fire.
Right, that's no good.
No. So,
listen,
be a darling, douse yourself in petrol, okay?
But I...
Yeah, you're my man. Good talk. Good talk. You're my favourite. Love you, Gary.
Really?
Yeah. I'll see you soon. See you soon.
I just wanna...
Again.
were you eating Special K in there again?
A spider frightened me and I spilled it down the drain. It's all in my hair.
What?
Oh, and it's on the puppet.
You sort it out yourself this time.
Dad, library. 5 minutes.
It's not really a library, is it? I guess you'd say it's the beginnings of a library. You think that your mother's not here, we could call it a study.
Dad, if you do this fire stunt, I want you to know there's going to be consequences. Oh, I'll make sure of that.
What, so you want them to use CGI?
Yes.
That's the stuntman's greatest enemy. Sweetie, look, I can see you're upset, okay? I want you to know that's a perfectly natural response.
Dad, stop emoting.
No, I'm not emoting. If anything, I'd say I was empathising.
Oh, you can tell Gary's really listening. Sure, he's a kick-ass stuntman, but he's a father first.
You know, if we actually got another shelf, we could call it a library. Did you see your footsteps?
No.
Uh-oh.
Trish! Terrific to see you. Didn't our attorneys agree on 24 hours notice?
Hi, Mum.
Hi, sweetheart. What have you done to my library?
Hang on a second, Trish. It's my library too.
Not legally.
I contributed.
Yeah, I'm sure Gary would have contributed. Oh, hang on. Somebody's written something down for me. Ahem. When Gary and Trish graduated in accounting, Trish went on to work as a senior analyst at the Liberal Treasury think tank. Gary, however, decided to follow his dreams and enrol in leisure studies at Wellington Taff. And in no time at all, it paid off. After changing over to feminist studies, and then quickly to masculine studies, Gary eventually found his calling. He made a career out of punishing himself on camera. A little bit like Tom Cruise.
Beth, are you sure you're all right with this arrangement?
Yes, Mum.
Just say the word and I'll sell this place.
I'm fine, honestly, Mum.
Trish, do you have to take those right away? You're depleting the library.
Sort yourself out, Gary. It's not even cute anymore.
It's your library.
Bye, sweetie.
Bye, Mum.
Gary.
Now then, what's Beth up to? Oh, she's taking photographs of things.
Hello, I'm thinking about this piano you've got for sale. Am I right in believing it's the one that Elton John wrote, Candle in the Window? And the swing work, are you sure he wore it? Hey, hiya, it's me again.
There'd be consequences.
You can't just up and sell my stuff.
I had to raise money for your funeral.
Do you have any idea how stressed that I am right now about this mole?
You know what, Dad? Do whatever the hell you want. I'm done.
Oh, doesn't Gary look really upset? Is nobody going to help him?
In all the old familiar places that this heart of mine embraces all day through. In that small cafe, the park across...
I know what you're thinking. You think Gary's going to throw himself in. But don't worry about it. He's a really good stuntman.
G'day, Gary speaking.
Hey, Gary, it's me, Patel.
Hey, Dr. Patel.
Look, I just wanted to give you a call about the fiery stunt you got coming up. You, me, and Brad Pitt just sort of hanging out and things. I just want to make sure that, you know, that I'm there. I'll be ready to be there just to make sure that we're all okay.
Save your breath. I'm not even sure I'm doing it.
Oh, but Gary, you must.
What about my mole? Is it bad?
Hang on. Just got to call on the other line.
Can we talk about
Come on,
this?
Doc. Put his mind at rest.
Oh, God. It's pretty serious.
Serious?
Sorry. It's just it's my wife. I'm going to get in trouble again.
What about my mole?
No, sorry, look, I've really got to go. It's just, it's the beatings that take a toll.
She beats you?
Just a little bit. I've got to go, Gary. Look, I'll talk to you later, okay?
Fine.
Talk to you
Whatever.
Soon. All right, cheers.
See
bye.
You, bye.
You know, I had a mole once.
Hi.
But it went away.
The thing is, sweetie, I just don't think we can get the house comfortable for you.
Babe, I could move my exercycle out of the spare bedroom.
Oh, no, the Commonwealth trials are next week.
Ah, yeah, that's true.
Well, I could sleep on the sofa bed.
Oh, no, it's not comfortable.
All right.
Well, it's up to you.
How about I move the spare car out of the garage?
Not the convertible.
Oh, yeah, no, it could rain, I suppose.
Hello.
What time is it?
6 o'clock?
6:05.
I'm sorry, my sweet little Mandarin.
You were with him again, weren't you?
No, I was at surgery. And anyway, he's my best friend.
Vijay, put your mango lassi down. Repeat after me. I am not part of Hollywood.
I'm not a part of Hollywood.
I am not a part of Bollywood.
In Bollywood.
And I am not and will never be a part of Wellywood.
Don't make me say that.
AJ?
I'm going through a tunnel now. Oh, breaking up. Hello, Biff? It's Patel. Can you put Gary on? Gary, I was just reading this article about Brad Pitt.
Hey, sweetie, look, I'm really sorry about what went down before. It's just, you know, what I do, I think that's important, you know, entertaining people, especially in these difficult times, and...
That is exactly how I feel about my puppets.
Where's my daughter?
She's not upstairs.
She's at her mother's.
Wait, can you not leave me this time?
I'll wait in the car till you get dressed. Oh, and please don't bring that puppet.
Hi. Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm Gary, Beth's father.
Gary, oh, great to finally meet you. My name's Clark.
Hey, Clark. How you doing?
Gary.
Trish, I'm here to get my daughter.
You don't just get her, Gary. She's not some minor role in a Baz Luhrmann tragedy.
Oh, very good. Thank you. Enough of your Australian-specific put-downs. I just want to speak with my daughter.
Oh, this looks serious. I had to step out for a while. Have I missed anything?
Bless you for being an angel just when it seemed that heaven was not.
Hi. Any chance you might want to swap this little bayfront spot of yours for a little house in the country?
No, I like it open planned.
You want me to take my shoes off or?
I'd appreciate that. And the socks.
Touché.
Thank you.
Beth.
I'm sorry that I tried to sell you things. I just didn't want you to get hurt.
Now look. Sweetie, it's me who should be apologising, you know? I didn't listen to you and I should have.
You know Mum's not coming back, don't you?
Yeah.
She's with that young hot guy.
Excuse me?
Well, let's face it, Dad. He's won medals. He's a medalist.
What?
What are you? You dress up as other people and fall down.
That's what a stuntman does. Dressing up as other people and falling down. Are we having an apology here or what?
I really don't know.
You want to get out of here?
Yeah.
Go on. Albert!
Yeah, Michael, we need to be rolling film, okay? We can't have coffee breaks every 2 minutes. Can we just roll film? I just want to get something. I just want to get something on film.
Let's get on. What are we on to next?
It's the Woody the fire.
Oh, yeah. We've got some. Mr. Stuntman? Okay, when you give that fireman over there the signal, you know, hands up sort of thing, he's going to light you up.
Like a jackling stick.
Good luck.
Right, let's get on with it.
Yeah, so enough about saving lives. It's just what I do. What are you listening to on there?
Justin Bieber.
Oh, yeah. I've heard good things.
Like what?
Music?
What do you want on the reel?
My name.
I'm not doing this. Best right.
Excuse me?
I don't need to prove anything.
What the hell? Who is this guy?
I've realised I've been doing this stunt for all the wrong reasons. It's not about me.
No kidding, dipshit. This is a Brad Pitt $100 million film.
I don't even know your name. I'm Gary.
What?
I'm out, everyone.
Oh, that's my signal.
I'm done.
Jump here. Somebody got that on film.
Must be Ruben.
Did you get that on film?
Get what on film?
Was the camera rolling? Look! Tell me. I told you to keep the camera rolling. We've got plenty of film.
No, we don't.
That was our last reel.
You're kidding. Oh, well, I always wanted to use CGI.
Ah, computer graphic.
I love CGI.
Yeah, I like it. It's good.
Did you get hold of Weta?
Yeah, they didn't return my calls.
Oh, that was unexpected. This is why I don't like sticking to a script. Real life's unpredictable. You have to improvise, you know, like a jazz percussionist or an improviser.
Gary!
Hey, Doc.
So, the bad news is you've got second degree burns to your arms.
Okay, so what's the good news?
The good news is the mole's burned right off.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it's the healing power of the human body. And of fire.
So I don't need the test then?
Oh God, no, still need to do the test. We have to get that scan in.
Scan?
Oh, Grey's Anatomy.
What, is that it? Surely that's not the end. You haven't even answered any questions. Well, has he got cancer or what, Gary? Well, I'll tell you something. Don't ask me to come back and do this job again. Well, it's just shoddy. I mean, your toilet's too far away for a start. I had to go to the toilet, I've got a bladder infection. And then you carried on filming, so, you know, I missed half of my narration. I'll tell you what, I'm not coming all the way back to New Zealand again to do a job like this. You can forget it. On top of the world, I'm rolling.